Did you know, using popular gay dating apps might out yourself? That would not be a problem for some, but in places where legal protection against discrimination is weak nor non-existent, outing can jeopardize one's career and family relationships. How vulnerable users of dating apps could be? Let's find out. Grindr and Jack'd are two dating apps popular in the gay community. They help us discover others who are geographically close to us. These apps do not talk to each other directly. They need to get information from the servers of the platforms. Data from your phone travel through a complex network infrastructure before reaching a destination. Usually, a wireless access point in your home or office is the only part visible to you. There exist a number of ways for mobile phone apps to communicate with servers. For the sake of simplicity, here, let's just discuss two commonly used protocols, HTTP and HTTPS. The difference between the two is encryption. Data sent through HTTP are not protected by encryption. They are almost open for every intermediate network device between your phone and the servers to read. By contrast, HTTPS is an encrypted channel. The data are not understood by anyone but the parties at each end. An analogy may help explain HTTP. Suppose a sender wants to send a message to a recipient. He writes his message on a postcard. The post office knows the origin, destination, and the content. Sending data through HTTP is like sending a postcard. The sender has no intention to prevent others from knowing the content. I guess most of you are using these apps without paying for the premium features, aren't you? So, how do they make money? Actually, Grindr and Jack'd on your phone also talk to a third-party service called MoPub. MoPub is an advertising platform for app developers to monetize their apps out of users' data. Grindr and Jack'd talk to their servers through HTTPS, a channel with encryption. However, they talk to MoPub through HTTP, a channel without encryption. So, let's take a look at what Grindr and Jack'd sent from your phone to MoPub using a postcard. Tools are readily available for network administrators to read unencrypted traffic. Grindr sends your gender, age, location coordinates, and your device identifier to MoPub without encryption. Similarly, Jack'd sends your gender, age, marital status, location coordinates, and your device identifier to MoPub without encryption. Grindr and Jack'd send the same unique device identifier to MoPub. MoPub could use this ID to track how often you use Grindr, Jack'd, and all other apps with MoPub banners embedded. HTTP logging is not an advanced feature for network equipment. Most consumer-grade routers come with the feature to record web access history of the clients. In the workplace, network managers can easily identify devices running a gay app, and of course the user's real identity. At home, those who have administrative access to the router may easily know what apps their family members are using. Surveillance is just an administrative matter. Gay people may unintentionally out themselves while using dating apps. It can be a big issue in societies in which homophobia is still rampant. Before the acceptance of sexual minorities becomes a norm across the globe, there are places where gay people stay in closets in fear of unfair treatment and social exclusion. Some may dismiss my concern because being spied on by employers and family seems unusual. The problem is, what if spying is not that hard? In these examples, I show how live detection of gay apps is possible by running a simple script on a network gateway machine. This program reads unprotected HTTP traffic to detect the presence of Grindr and Jack'd.
It is not hard at all to sniff network traffic to intercept some user data from gay dating apps. The app developers should be more careful with their choice of third-party services. This issue should be rectified as soon as possible. Mobile devices stay with us almost 24/7. We should have a better understanding of how these intimate objects work. Thank you for watching.